Hello, my name is Helena Duggan, and this is my book, A Place Called Perfect. So, Perfect is about a boy and a girl called Violet and Boy, because boys don't need names. Girls are much more important than boys. And I came up with the idea to these glasses. Oh, can you see them there? If you've read the book, you might notice the address on the label is one that's very important in the book. Now, I will read you the first chapter from the story and see what you think. Okay, chapter one, Boy. He waited, hidden by dusk in the garden bushes against the bark of an oak tree, watching. The spot gave him full view of the house and gravel driveway. Worrying about being seen felt weird. Perfect had been alive with the news of Dr. Eugene Brown's arrival for weeks. The doctor would help. Boy knew it more than he'd ever known anything. He just had to get to the man before he changed. As night closed in, George and Edward Archer strode by and mounted the stone steps to the house. The place lit up, and Boy watched them move around inside. Suddenly, light darted across the grass by his feet, and Boy pulled back further into the shadows. A silver car crunched along the driveway towards him and stopped. His heartbeat quickened. The engine purred to silence. The large door of the house opened and the Archer twins stood silhouetted in the light from the hallway. As Boy watched, statue still, a shiver danced down his spine. The car door swung open again, and this time a small, frightened girl dashed out across the gravel toward the house. Boy couldn't help laughing. She sped up, jumped the steps and rushed in through the front door, banging it shut behind her, and plunged the yard back into darkness. The car door hung open and Boy pushed it shut as he edged closer to the kitchen window. He just caught sight of the girl sliding into the room. He sat down by the steps to wait. Night rolled on. The watchers would be patrolling soon and he couldn't be caught outside the walls again. He'd come back in the morning, early, and speak to the doctor then. He took one last look in the window. The girl sat between her mum and dad, a proper family. Something inside him stung as he rubbed the worn note in his pocket. And, oh yes, sorry. I forgot I was being filmed. So, that's the first chapter of Perfect. And I hope you like the rest of it if you get a chance to read it. And of course, boys do deserve names as well. But just maybe not this boy for a while. Thank you. Bye.